Hey everybody, I've been working on a little project where I'm creating a multiplayer 2D game that is top-down. Started working with visual scripting a little while ago, so I thought I'd show how to add visual scripting to a player object inside of Unity and how easy it is to do with visual scripting. It really is easy. In our Unity editor, I'm using 2021 in this particular case. I've already created my player. It is a standard capsule that I created just simply as a 2D game object sprite. Just added the capsule, added rigid body 2D to it. And now I'm going to add the visual scripting. So just with your player selected, click Add Component, type in Script, and select Script Machine. That'll open up a Script Machine component. And let's go ahead and create a new one. And I'm going to call this my player movement. And go ahead and give it a title, just for fun's sake, and click your edit tool. I'm going to move it up here so I have plenty of room. So for player movement, we usually don't use on start or on update. Instead, we use on fixed update. So let's get rid of these two because we're not going to use them. And right click, and we're going to add the on fixed. So I'm going to type that in here at the top, on fixed update. So we're going to be changing the player's velocity, which would be a rigid body 2D object. So let's go ahead and add a node. And this is going to be rigid body velocity. Let's go with velocity. And there we go, rigid body 2D velocity. And we'll go ahead and connect our run between the two. Now it's already got this selected, which of course this object is this is going to be applied to whatever script this is attached to. So let's then go ahead and add our capturing our player movement from either the keyboard, control device, gamepad, whatever the player's using. And I am still using input manager because, it works, but this will work just as easily for system input manager or whatever input manager that you're using, as long as, you've got everything set. We need to get the player's input axis. So add a node and we're going to get axis, input get axis, the axis name. And I'm going to need that twice, once for horizontal and once for vertical. As I said, this is a top-down game, so I'm going to be moving up and down and left and right. So let's go ahead and duplicate this. And one's going to be vertical for the axis name, and the other one's going to be horizontal. And then finally, we need to convert these to our vector. Our 2D vector, how they're going to move. So we're going to add another node. So this would be vector 2. And we need to create this. And we're going to want the XY version because we're giving it X and Y input. And connect to our X and connect to our Y. And connect the output. And there we have it. We've got a simple movement system. Well, let's play it to make sure. Go here to play, let it do all of its compiling. And then this is now, right now it's attached to both my player and my enemy character, which will be the other player. So I need to pull that off. So if you would like to learn more about creating multiplayer games, make sure you subscribe and like the video. Tell me in the comments what kind of 2D multiplayer environment you would like to see for something like this. I'll be happy to create this. Textbook is or a book on how to do this is coming very, very soon. Should be just a few weeks away. That book is coming right along. So if you haven't yet, go over to Burton's Media Group and make sure you subscribe to my email list to learn when the book is available. The link is down below in the description. Thanks.